Hello and welcome to Sudoku. In today's video, we are going to talk about the use cases for PubSub messaging pattern. This is a part 2 of the previous video where we have discussed in detail what is a PubSub pattern using some analogies and a real world example. In this video, we will understand what are the real world use cases that require PubSub pattern to be implemented and applied. And also we will discuss few cases where you should consider not using this pattern because it might become an overkill to your system or application, and maybe it is not needed that much. Complicated pattern is not even needed for your use case. So the aim of this video is to help you understand different use cases of PubSub pattern so that you can effectively identify where this pattern is used and how you can utilize this pattern in any of the problems that you might be working on at your work currently. So let's get started. The very first use case is asynchronous workflow. I hope by now you understand the meaning of asynchronous. It means that particular action is being done in background or asynchronously. The person or the component which has asked for a particular task to be done is not waiting for a response. So that is asynchronous or async. Workflow in terms of business or in terms of system defines a business workflow. For example, in an e-commerce website, if an order is placed, as soon as the order is placed, there has to be notifications to the customer that your order has been placed through email, SMS, etc. There has to be a communication to the warehouse that a request for this order has come. Please pack it and ship it. There has to be a communication to the finance department that an order has been placed for this customer. You have to generate the invoice. There also has to be a communication to different finance person or like someone who handles the operations and vendors who can tell that particular seller, connect to that particular seller and prompt them that this order has been placed, you have to take care of the delivery, or this order has been placed and a certain amount of payment has to be made to that seller. For example, Amazon is a platform where sellers sell their products, right? So when a product is purchased, a certain amount of money goes to that seller as well, and it is the responsibility of the platform to take care of that workflow. So all these examples that I'm giving, these are examples of workflows. Now, some workflows have to happen instantaneously. For example, as soon as the customer clicks on the button add cart, that item should be available in the cart. That cannot happen in an async processing. It has to be synchronous. The moment customer clicks on the button add cart, the item should start showing up in the cart and they should be able to place an order. But once an order is placed, it is okay for the business or the tech to handle the workflows like generating invoice for that order, contacting the seller and giving them the payout for certain order. All these can happen in background or through async workflows. So when there is a requirement of one or two workflows or multiple async workflows, PubSub pattern can work in that way, where a publisher just subscribes a particular message like payout to the seller, and the subscriber who is responsible of taking care of that transaction, that money transaction to seller's account, they can pick that message and process it in an asynchronous manner, because that processing is not stopping from the customer to go ahead with placing the order and completing the transaction. Right? So in such scenarios where there are asynchronous workflows, PubSub pattern comes in handy. Second use case is decoupling. For example, a website wants to track every click and every action taken by a user on the website and wants to save that data on the backend for some analytics. Now, whenever a user is clicking on a button or interacting with any elements, think how many events would be generated or how many actions would be taken by that user in a minute. And if all those events have to be processed on the backend or stored on the backend, the user interface cannot be blocked for that. The user interface is still have to be keep working and not block on how much time the backend is taking to processing those events. So in that case, PubSub messaging can work. Why? Because all the user events can be queued into a queue or the input channel of the publisher, and then the subscribers who are supposed to take those events and save them somewhere in a data store, they can do that by picking those messages from the queue, and UI will be unblocked. So again, it's one of the benefit and it's one of the foundations of queuing patterns decoupling. So that is the second use case.
Third use case is load balancing. If you just think about the case from the decoupling where the UI events are getting tracked and with every UI interaction, a message is sent in a queue to save it, how load balancing can happen there is the UI can send as many messages as they want and the number of subscribers on the backend can be increased or since the messages are getting pushed into a queue, the UI is not getting blocked and if the number of messages from the UI increases, all those messages are getting queued and the number of subscribers can be increased. So you're able to balance the load and you can handle a large throughput, a large number of messages if there are message queues in between. On the other hand, if the same thing is happening through an API where the response is returned quickly or every event is first stored, like every event as soon as it is generated to the backend, it is stored. In that case, storing will take some time. And if there are a lot of messages, it can block the DB or it can block the processing or the backend application itself. So message queues and PubSub messaging patterns help in load balancing such kind of heavy throughput loads. One more use case is deferred processing. The word deferred means that do it later or maybe put it in a backlog kind of thing. A deferred and asynchronous workflow are kind of same, but I'll tell you a use case of deferred processing. For example, at the end of the day, all the invoices for all the customers who have placed order in that day have to be uploaded to S3. Now, in order to do that, the information of customer have to be fetched, information of orders have to be fetched, and then calculations have to be done. And then you build invoice and then you upload it to S3 or some other store. Now, doing this during peak hours when people are placing orders and the site is up and running might be risky because if for carrying out this process, you're trying to read from the DBs, it might be difficult because already DBs and the systems are busy. So what can be done using messaging patterns or PubSub patterns is that you put a certain message in a queue and defer it until later on. Like you put a time or you schedule it that this has to be done at a later time. And that message stays in the queue and according to the scheduled time when off-peak hours are there, at that scheduled time, that message is picked up and the background processing for uploading the invoices to the S3 could be done easily. Another use case is data streaming. For example, think about some IoT devices like sensors that are attached to streetlights or maybe some cameras which are pushing data continuously to the backend. That can be very easily handled through PubSub pattern because a lot of data can be entered into the system and different consumers and subscribers which have to react to that data or like have to perform some transformations over that data can do that because PubSub provides such huge scale. So this is another use case. I would love to talk about any of these things in detail. For example, data streaming systems, how analytical systems are built using different messaging patterns, or how microservice architecture is built and the communication is among those different microservices is done using messaging, and how the concept of eventual consistency comes in. I do want to talk about all these in detail, but just make sure that this is an introductory video where we are giving you an overview of PubSub pattern and where it can be used. We are going to discuss all these things as the course advances. Now, to summarize, when you should not use this pattern. For example, you have just 100 customers and you have, say, 60 orders coming in every day. Then you don't have to do this. Like you don't have to implement such complicated architecture because when you try to implement this architecture, you try to use this pattern, you have to have a good infra to support this and you have to have monitoring and alerting systems to keep a track of what is happening with your messaging systems. So do not try to overkill with a very small requirement where huge scale is not needed. Maybe this pattern is not needed. Then if your API or any feature needs instantaneous response, if you have to make real-time systems, the response should be available instantaneously in real time. In that cases, do not use this pattern because it might be as close to real time, but there is still going to be lags in certain systems because most of the tasks are deferred and are processed asynchronously. So when you have a requirement of real time systems, this pattern is not going to be useful. And one more use case is there are some cases where even in asynchronous messaging, you need an acknowledgement that the publisher has sent a message, and it might need an acknowledgement from the consumer or the subscriber that fine, I have received this message and it will be processed. In that case, this pattern itself is modified through application code and through different other libraries and systems where the acknowledgement piece is introduced, and there can be acknowledgement for different messages. So the point I'm trying to make here is that this same pattern can be coupled with other patterns or can be modified in order to serve the system needs, because every system would have different requirements. So that was a brief overview of different use cases for PubSub pattern and some use cases where you should not use it. If you want to go into detail, I have linked different documents from Microsoft, Google, AWS, etc. about this pattern and how the different products that these guys have built for addressing these patterns, different factors that you have to consider, and much more details related patterns. Everything is included in the description. Please check it out. If you have any doubts related to this video, please feel free to ask in comments. I'll try to answer as much as possible. Till then, take care. See you in the next video. Thank you.